In this video, you will learn how to set up conditions in a report using action states. There are key advantages to setting up conditions in report design. If a report is set to capture all information, it may capture a large volume of documents with a significant risk of missing key information, overlooking small details, and spending more time browsing unimportant data. With condition-based reports, we expect to save time, going right to the point and providing more details only when required. So let's move on to an exercise. Our task is monitor PI tag BA level 1 and show only trend data when tank level is high. We will begin by creating the action state. Go to File, New, Batch Report Template. Name it Exception Report and click on OK. Now in the data template, right-click on the batch and select Insert, Journal Action, name it Tag Limit Check. Now let's create the 7 action parameters listed in the table on your screen. If you are following along with the exercise, I recommend pausing the video here and setting up the action parameters yourself, as you are already familiar with the process. I will fast forward the video and when we resume, you will see that my action parameters are also set up and ready to go. Moving on to the Journal Action Edit and the Action Options tab, drag sampling time from the left to the interval field. Now switch to the action states tab, click on the green plus icon to add a new state. Name it in range index 1. Click on the green plus again, state name low, index 2. Again green plus, state name high, index 3. Let's select the InRange Index 1 state, check the Default State box, click the Transition Equation space, and look at the if-else statements that I put for you in the box and type it there. And now copy the entire equation and paste it into the transition equation space of the state name low and high. Select the InRange state, go to the results definition section, click on the green plus name message, type simple, drag InRange message from the left to the value field on the right. Select the low state. In the result definition section, click on the green plus icon. Name it message. Type simple. Drag low message from the left to the value field on the right. Now select the high state. In the results definition section, click on the green plus icon. Name it message. Type simple, drag high message from the left to the value field on the right. Click on the green plus icon again and name it trend, select type trend. Drag data source from the left to the data source field on the right. If you want, you can also customize the trend to hide the legend and the title. To do so, click on properties. Now save your report template, go to View and Test Report, select Use Event Frames, make sure you are connected to server PySRV01 and the database TID database, click on Search, select a completed procedure event frame and click on OK. Now let's have a quick look at the data journal. Browse the journal up to the results of the tag limit check journal action. You will notice the terminal states and the sequence entries notes. Both notes contain the same information, although it is organized differently. The terminal states should have 3 entries in range low and high. All state results will be gathered under one of them. The sequence entries will show the same information but in sequential order. Since we need a table listing the different states, we'll work with the sequence entries node. You can also notice that the terminal states are split by each action state, and the sequence entries are ordered chronologically. Okay, let's switch to the Format Template tab and create a new section. Select the entry, insert, table. For the node name type alarms, we want to have one row and four columns. Go to the border tab for the frame select border, for the border width one, and click on OK. Now expand the alarms table, rename the table row to values. Expand the values row and rename each table data to state, start time, end time, and trend. Select the values row, copy it, select the table header, paste it there, and rename values to labels. Expand the labels row, select each table data, insert, text, and the text will be the same as column's name. To set up iterator for the sequence entries journal entry, double-click the values row, go to the expressions tab, browse and drag the data item you can see on the screen to the iterator field. Select the state table data cell, insert data, browse and drag results, result label message value to the source field. Select the start time table data cell, insert UTC time, browse and drag a start time UTC seconds to the source field. Select the end time table data cell, insert UTC time, browse and drag end time UTC seconds to the source field. And now finally select the trend table data cell, insert trend, browse and drag results, result label trend value to the source field. You must search for a high journal entry with two results to find it. Now you can save your report template and hit F5 on your keyboard or click on refresh. And now your report is ready. I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.